Okay, good afternoon, everybody. So in the previous class, we discussed about the various types of numericals which we so far studied in the flywheel. Okay, the type one was T-theta diagram was given in the question. Okay, in type two numericals, T-theta diagram wasn't given, but details of it was given in the text form. Okay, so by that text, we will plot the diagram and then solve the question. In third type, the T theta diagram was not given, but the equation for it was given. Okay, so with the help of equation, we'll plot the diagram and solve it further. In type four, the multi-cylinder engine was taken into consideration, and how the T theta diagram was to be drawn and comprehended, and further how the combined diagram was to be drawn, that we saw. All right. Now, in the previous class, we started basics about the type 5, that is the application of flywheel in punching and riveting machines, right? So, let's quickly revise that, what we saw in the previous lecture. So, the E1 was the energy required by the punching or riveting operation for the X seconds, right? So, the time parameter also came into the picture when we are talking about machines, such as punching machine and riveting machine, because the electricity consumption would be a significant thing. Okay, then E2 was the energy supplied by the motor during the X time duration. So the fluctuation of energy small e would be equals to E1 minus E2. All right, this we understood by the help of example also, that E1 was the E1 was 10 kilojoule of energy required in one punching operation, and it takes 1 second. So for one punching operation, the energy required is 10,000 joules, right? 10 kilojoule would be equals to 10,000 joules, and that time is 1 second. Okay, and E2, what was E2? E2 is the energy available, that is energy provided by the motor, supplied by the motor. All right, if the motor rating is 10 kilowatt, then the E2, the value of E2 will be again 10,000 joule. And when we find out the fluctuation of energy, that is small e, it will come out to be zero. When the fluctuation of energy is zero, that means we do not require a flywheel. Now, when we will require the flywheel? If the rated power of the motor is less than what is required to us, right? So we require 10 kilojoule of energy for one punching operation, and it takes 1 second. And the power or the work provided by the motor is of 5 kilowatt. 5 kilowatt means 5,000 watts, and 5,000 watts means 5,000 joules per second. So in this question, our requirement, that is E1, it is 10,000 joule in 1 second. That is 10,000 joule per second for doing the operation. Okay, but the motor is providing only 5,000 joules. Okay, so in this case, when we find out the fluctuation of energy, that is E is equals to E1 minus E2, it comes out to be 5,000 joule, and hence we require the flywheel in this case. Okay, also we saw if the time is punching time or the operation time is more than 1 second, let's say it was 1.5 seconds, then the motor would be providing us only 7,500 joules. And our requirement will be 10,000 joules. Okay, so again in that case we need flywheel. All right, once we have sorted this out that we need a flywheel, then the next question comes that what mass of flywheel is required. Okay, so that we can that thing we can so determine by using this equation E is equals to I CS omega mean square, and this I consists of mass of the flywheel and omega radius of gyration of the flywheel. All right, so this is what is required. Okay, okay, so from E2, see E2 is the motor, E2 is the amount of power which the motor can supply to us. Okay, so the motor, there are different varieties of motor available in the market, and they are when you go to market to purchase a motor, it will be they will ask you for the specification, and you have to give the specification, maybe according to its speed or maybe according to the power it consumes, okay, or according to the wattage. So we are talking about the wattage. So this is 10 kilowatt. Its rating is 10 kilowatt. In second case, its rating is 5 kilowatt. So in 10 kilowatt, what does the kilowatt means? Kilowatt means kilojoules per second. Okay. So this much, 10,000 kilojoules of energy it will provide every second. Okay. So according to that, accordingly, it will consume the electricity also. This in the second case, the rating of the motor is 5 kilowatt. 5 kilowatt means 5000 watt, and 5000 watts means 5000 joules per second. Okay. In the previous class we discussed how the these basics of these basic units are interrelated to each other, right? So I'll just let you know once again that in 1 watt, this watt is a derived unit, right? This watt is derived of, and this is consists of two quantities. One is the energy quantity of joule, and second is the time quantity, that is in seconds. So amount of energy consumed or provided per unit time. So joule per second makes the unit watt. Okay, and this joule, it is again a derived quantity. It is made up of two quantities, that is Newton and meter. Okay. So this we have to remember very thoroughly, because it will be extensively used in these questions, because the units will not be consistent in the question, but we have to bring it in similar units, that is SI units, and then solve the question. Okay. Now even won't change in any case. The even a requirement to do the punching operation, because we would be doing punching operation on a particular piece of metal, and that metal will not change. Okay, so the energy required in punching operation would be same, but E2 will change depending upon the time required for one operation. So as per the time, if the punching time increases further, the energy requirement will be more, and hence the flywheel requirement will also vary. All right, so this is what we already discussed in the morning class. Okay, in the previous class. Now let's move forward. So in today's in this lecture, we are going to see further more details of this operation, and we'll go in more detail. Now, how this is quantified, that how much energy is required. So you'll see this is your punching machine. Okay, this part of the machine is punch. Okay, and its motion is to and fro motion. That is, it moves up and down. All right, and this is our plate or job. Okay, and this job is placed over die. Okay, this job is placed over a die, and this punch comes down, and the shearing process takes place, and this much amount of part of this sheet will be removed and fell down. Okay, so this is basically the punching operation. Now at a particular angle, that is angle theta 1, see this you can clearly see that this arrangement is very similar to sliding crank mechanism, right? So like our IC engine. So this is kind of piston, this is connecting rod, this is crank, and this is fixed link. Okay, so this is another inversion of four slider crank mechanism. All right, so let's see from this horizontal line, at some particular angle theta 1, the position of this punch is such that it is just about to touch the plate. Okay, it is just above the plate. The punching operation hasn't started yet, but the punch has reached at the top of plate, such that in very next second it will do the punching operation. All right. And then this next position, that is theta 2, let me take another color. This next position, that is theta 2. This theta 2, what does it define? this theta 2 is the position of this punch when the punching operation is completed. Okay, so the punch has moved from this position to this second position, this position 1 to position 2. Punch has moved from position 1 to position 2. That is this, its cutting plane, that is the shearing plane, has moved from position 1 to position 2. And this much portion of punching process only requires the energy, that is maximum amount of energy, that is E1. Okay, rest of the time when this punch is moving, rest of the time when this punch is moving to and fro, it does not require much amount of energy as much it is required while during this punching operation, that is moving from position 1 to 2. That's why we have taken this theta 1, this angle theta 1 from this horizontal as one position, and this another angle theta 2. Okay, this is this angle is theta 2 from this horizontal plane. This angle is theta 2 and this angle is theta 1. So I hope you are able to see this properly, and it is rotating in like this. So this link acts as the crank, this second link acts as the connecting rod, and this punch, this acts as the piston. So now you will be easily visualize it, that when the crank rotates, when the crank rotates 360 degree, what happens to this punch? This punch moves up and down, and in one punch movement only one operation is happening. Okay, only one this job is getting created. Okay, so how much the punch has moved while doing the work? It has moved from position 1 to position 2, and that distance is nothing but equal to the thickness of this plate. Okay, so while doing this operation only, we require the energy E1, and E1, this energy E1 was equals to, let's say, 10,000 joules. We will continue this example. So during this time only, that is when the position of the this crank moves from theta 1 to theta 2, or the punch has moved this distance T, only during this time most amount of energy is required. Rest of the time the punch is idle, so no extra energy is required. All right, so let's quantify this with the help of similar triangle properties or proportionality. Now this theta 1 minus theta 2 minus theta 1, this angle, this is circular. Okay, this angle theta 2 minus theta 1 upon 2 pi, that is the total rotation. Total rotation is how much? It is equals to 2 pi. Okay, and this small distance, angular distance, is theta 2 minus theta 1. Okay, now this will be proportional to what? This linear distance moved by the punch divided by the total distance moved by the punch during this 2 pi. So what will be the total distance? Like this will be equals to 2 times the stroke. This is very similar to L by R ratio, LD ratio, that is 2 times the diameter of the crank is equals to length of the stroke. Okay, right, 2 times the diameter of crank is equals to length of the stroke. So once the crank starts rotating from this horizontal position, the punch will start moving down, and the crank once come over here in the in this horizontal position, that is half revolution, the crank has moved from its top dead center to bottom dead center. Okay, so that much of angle is pi. Now again punch will move, that is return stroke, punch will move from this horizontal position to its initial position, right? So this would be the return stroke, and the punch will travel from bottom dead center to top dead center. So this will be this we won't need any energy while reverse stroke, but while forward stroke we will be needing energy only during this time. Okay, so this is what is required over here, right? So this is another thing which is very important, which I wanted to share, that theta 2 minus theta 1, that is theta 2 minus theta 1 upon 2 pi upon the entire angle, right, is equals to T. This is linear distance T, and this is angular distance. These two are equal. Okay, so this angular distance, this is what will be the angular distance from theta 2 to theta 1? That is theta 2 minus theta 1. This is the angular distance in which the punch will be required the maximum energy, that is the value of E1, which we took as 10,000 joules, for example. Right. So during this punching or shearing operation only, the maximum amount of energy, that is 10,000 joules, which is equals to E1, is required. For rest of the time, for the punch to move ideally from top dead center to bottom dead center, that much amount of energy is not required. Okay, a small amount of energy is required just to overcome the inertia and keep the machine running. But maximum amount of energy is required only during this operation time. Okay, so what is the angular distance? That angular distance will be theta 2 minus theta 1. So this is what is written over here, theta 2 minus theta 1. And it is divided by the total angular distance which is traveled. So total angular distance, it comprises of a circle. A circle is of total angle 2 pi. Okay, this complete rotation is of 2 pi. So distance during which, angular distance during which the operation is happening, divided by the total angular distance traveled by the crank. Okay, and this we have equated to the linear distance which is traveled by the punch. This linear distance, what it is? It is nothing but the thickness of plate. So this linear distance which the punch has traveled while doing the operation is written over here. And this total travel, this total travel of the punch, how much will be that? That is first moving from top dead center to bottom dead center, that is one stroke length, then moving back from bottom dead center to top dead center, that is again this distance will be L. So L plus L, that will be two times of L, that is two times of stroke. Okay, this stroke length. So it is very analogous to your IC engine. Okay, the one complete rotation of crank is two strokes, one is forward stroke, one is return stroke of the piston, and the length, this length, that is radius of the crank, will be equals to two times the radius of the crank will be equals to stroke length. Okay, so since this stroke, the punch is traveling two times the same distance from top dead center to bottom dead center, while the crank is rotating two times, the crank, complete rotation of the crank, that's why this linear distance is written over here. So once again, angular distance during the punch time divided by the total angular distance, that is 2 pi, it is equated to, here there is equal to sign. All right, so don't get confused, this is equal to T, that is linear distance which the punch has traveled during the operation time, that is T, divided by the total distance of the punch, total travel of the punch, that is two times the stroke. This stroke is denoted by S. All right, and also we know that this stroke is two times the crank length, right? So the assumptions which we have taken are that one punch is done per revolution. So you can see clearly over here that only one punch is done, only one punching operation is done during the revolution of the one revolution of the crank. Okay, now all right, the E1 is the energy required by the punching operation. Okay, that is energy required per revolution. Since only one punching operation is happening in one revolution, therefore E1 is the energy required per revolution. Okay, so this is sorted. Now second, E2 is the energy supplied by motor during one punching time. Okay, during one punching operation, so energy which will be required by us would be E1 multiplied by this angular distance which we have traveled. Okay, because only during this percentage of the angular distance we need the value E1. Okay, so that much we want from the motor. So E2 will be E1 multiplied by the amount of time for which, amount of angular distance for which the that much of amount of energy is required. Okay, because rest of the time the machine is idle, no force is acting against it. Okay, so it will not require maximum amount of energy. Okay, so this is E1 and E2. Now for riveting or punching operation, RPM which is given will be taken as maximum RPM or omega max. Let's say the motor is rated at 1000 RPM. Okay, so this is very practical also. You all might have seen a motor which it might have been installed, or you might have seen somewhere this motor which pumps the water from underground tank to overhead tank, right? Many of you might be having at your home also, or any other motor, in the summer season you might have used cooler, right? So that cooler head also has a motor or pump. Okay, so what happens when you switch on the pump or motor, the RPM of the motor immediately reaches to its maximum RPM within a fraction of a second. Okay, so that's why whichever RPM is given to us, we take it as maximum RPM. Okay, this we will be needing in the question. This is very important point to be considered while doing the numericals. All right, now this E2 is equals to E1 minus E1 multiplied by theta 2 minus theta 1 upon 2 pi. So this angular distance we have taken and multiplied by it by E1 in order to determine what is the requirement from the motor. It is E2. Okay, so this equation is written over here. Now E, what is E? The fluctuation of energy. How do we calculate that? E1 minus E2. So this we have put, the E1 is taken common. Okay, so 1 minus theta 2 minus theta 1 by 2 pi, and this, what is this equal to? This is equals to thickness upon the 2 times the thickness upon 2 times the stroke length. Okay, this is T upon 2 times the stroke length. So T would be the thickness of plate and S would be the stroke length of the punch. Okay, how much punch is moving from top dead center to bottom dead center. So I hope this is clear to you. Okay, so these two relations are very important. Okay, now moving to the next. Now this is another thing which we need to understand, and another important concept of motor rating comes out from here. Okay, what would be the speed of the production? Okay, so it will be decided by the number of poles per unit time. So that time can be taken in minute basis, or that time can be taken in hourly basis. As per the conditions are given in question, we are going to use it accordingly. So number of poles per hour, how many number of holes a particular punching machine can do in an hour, that will be decided by this equation, that is energy supplied by motor during 1 hour. So energy supplied by motor during 1 hour, this will be in joules per second. This would be in joules. Okay, and energy required in one punching operation, again this will be in joules. Okay, so this joule will get cancelled, and number of this we will get the number of poles per hour. Okay, so how much energy is required during one punching operation, that we need to know. It will depend upon the thickness of the plate and the material of the plate, right? And energy supplied by the motor during 1 hour. Okay, so this we can know by the rating of the motor, and this is called the rating of the motor. Okay, in our question purpose, this will be called the rating of the motor. That is, if the rating is given 20 kilowatt, it means it can produce 20 kilojoules of energy per second. It can supply 20 kilojoules of energy per second. So that motor will be rated in such a manner. All right, if it is asked number of holes per minute, then how we'll calculate that energy supplied by motor during 1 minute. Okay, energy supplied by motor during 1 minute upon energy required in one punching operation. So this will be depending on the rating given in the question or the conditions mentioned in the question. Now let's look at this numerical in order to have a better understanding for this type of question. Now, electric motor, an electric motor drives a punching press which is fitted with a flywheel of radius of gyration 0.5 meter. So the value of K is given. See, I am writing the given data over here. Okay, this value of K is given to us, 0.5 meter. All right, the motor runs at 250 rpm. Now this speed is given to us, and in previous slide we saw that when the speed is given, so when the speed is given, we'll take it as maximum speed. All right, so this will be the value of since it is given in rpm, so n max is given to us. Okay, the value of n max is given to us. All right, now and the press is capable of punching 800 holes per hour. So this thing is given to us, LHS of this equation is given to us, that is 800 holes per hour. Okay, now each punching operation takes 1.5 seconds, so time is given to us, and requires 1200 newton meter of energy. Okay, I hope you remember what is newton meter. Newton meter is nothing but joules. Okay, newton meter is joules. So this much of energy is required in one punching operation, 12,000 newton meter. So 12,000 joules of energy is required in one punching operation, and this amount of energy, for how long we will be needing this energy? It will be for 1.5 seconds, because it is given that one punching operation takes 1.5 seconds. All right, so I hope this is making some sense. Now you might be able to visualize it, how these things are working. All right, now next, calculate rating of the motor in kilowatt. So this rating we do not know, this is to be calculated. All right, and also the mass of flywheel. Okay, so mass of flywheel is also required. If the speed does not drop below more than 2300 rpm, so n max is given to us, that is 250 rpm over here, and the minimum value of speed is also given, that is n min. All right, so we have to take this into consideration and solve the problem accordingly. So these things are given to us. Okay, I have not written the given data, I have directly started solving the question, but when you solve this in the exam or make notes in your notebook of these numericals, make sure that you first write all the given data which has been mentioned in the question. Okay, then start solving, because it is one of the step, and if it is not in the answer sheet, the marks will get deducted. All right, so E1 is given to us. Why it is E1? Because this much energy is required. Okay, now we are using this equation. The first thing which we need to calculate is the rating of motor. So rating of the motor will come from this equation. Okay, so what is given to us? This LHS is given to us as 800 holes per hour. 800 holes per hour. And since we do not know the rating, so we have written it as x watts. Okay, and this 3600 is multiplied. Why? Because per hour is asked, and in 1 hour, how many seconds are there? 60 multiplied by 60, that is 3600. Okay, so what will this become? What is watts? Watts is joule per second. Joule per second, and this is the unit of time, which is in seconds. So joules per second, the second and second will get cancelled. So the numerator will become joules, and this denominator, this will also become newton meter, that is joules, right? So joules and joules will get cancelled, so it will become unitless, just a number. All right, so x watts multiplied by the time and divided by this E1, that is energy required in one punching operation. Okay, so it comes out to be 2.67 kilowatt. So this becomes our motor rating. Okay, so this is what the first answer of our question is. That is, what was the question? Calculate the rating of the motor. Okay, so motor rating is 2.67 kilowatt or 2.67 into 10 raised to the power 3 joules per second. All right, so I hope this is clear to you. Now let's move on to what is asked next. So we need to calculate the mass of the flywheel. So as I told you, as we discussed earlier over here, flywheel, we can use this equation. We will use this equation. E is equals to ICS omega mean square. Or there is another equation for I and another equation for E. What was that? It was 1 by 2 I multiplied by omega max square minus omega min square. Okay. I hope you are revising all your previous lectures. So in those you will find this. Okay. Omega max minus omega min square. Okay. So this equation can also be used. I think this equation will be used because we have been given two values of RPM, right? That is, maximum RPM is given to us and minimum RPM is given to us. Okay, so let's move forward. Okay, so N max is 250 RPM and N min is 230 RPM. Okay, this is the value of N, but we need the value of omega. So I have calculated omega over here. By 2 pi n by omega is equals to 2 pi n by 60. Okay, mass of flywheel is required. So one equation of E is like this. Also E is equals to E1 minus E2. So E1, what is the value of E1? That is 12,000. And what is the value of E2? E2 is 2.67. This we calculated just now, right? 2.67 kilowatt. So 2.67 into 10 to the power 3 joules. Okay, and 2.67 into 10 to the power 3, and this is required for how much time? It is required for 1.5 seconds. Why? Because in question it has been given that the punching operation takes 1.5 seconds. All right, therefore the E2 will become this multiplied by this, it comes out to be 4000 Newton meter. So we'll calculate the fluctuation of energy. This is E1, this is E2, and E small e comes out to be 8000 Newton meter. Now this much amount of energy is required, extra amount of energy is required, which the flywheel will supply. Why? Because motor is rated at 2.67 kilowatt. Okay, and we need 8000 Newton meter. That is 8 kilowatts, right? Extra energy is needed. Original requirement was 12,000, but motor is giving only 4000. We need extra 8000. Okay, so where will we will get this from? We'll get this from flywheel. So what kind of flywheel do we need to employ? That we have to calculate. So this we'll equate this equation I is equals to ICS omega mean square, or this equation I was talking about, that I is equals to half E is equals to half multiplied by I multiplied by omega max square minus omega min square, right? So this value E is we have calculated as 8000. So 8000 we'll keep over here, multiplied by half. I is nothing but M multiplied by K square. So M is unknown to us. The value of K is given as 0.5 and it is squared, multiplied by omega max minus omega max square minus omega min square. So omega is 2 pi n by 60. So 2 pi n is 2 pi by 60 is taken common and squared, multiplied by 250 square minus 230 square. So when you will calculate this, you will get it as mass is equals to 608 kg. So I hope this is you are able to understand this. So first we calculated the rating of the motor, and second thing we calculated the mass of the flywheel. All right. So this is the simple approach which we need to do in such kind of questions. All right. So let me erase all this. Now let's move on to another question. In this question, it is given a 5 kilowatt induction motor running at 950 RPM. So see, the rating of motor is given that it can supply 5 kilowatts of power. What is kilowatt? It will be kilojoule per second. Okay, 5 kilojoule per second means 5000 joules per second. So it can provide 5000 joules of energy. All right, and it is running at a speed of 950 RPM. So this will be by default omega max. N max. Okay. Now it operates a riveting machine, right? The machine has flywheel of 100 kg. So mass is given and 0.4 meter as radius of gyration. The value of K is given. Now each riveting takes 1 second. So one riveting operation takes 1 second and requires 10 kilojoule of energy. So see, this is the value of our E1. E1 is given to us as 10,000 joules. And what is the value of E2? E2 would be 5000 multiplied by this time, operation time, that is 1 second. So E2 will be 5000 joules. Okay, so there is a deficiency in the supply. Okay, so definitely we have to use the flywheel. Okay, so let's read further. Calculate the fall in speed of flywheel after riveting operation and also the number of rivets closed per hour. So omega max is given to us, n max is given to us. It is asking us to calculate the minimum value of RPM, that is n minimum. Okay, so it is very straightforward question. Second thing which is asked is number of rivets per hour. So number of operations, how many number of operations it can do in an hour. So this is also asked. Now E1 is given to us, E2 is given to us, time is 1 second, so E2 will be equals to the rated power. Fluctuation of energy, this comes out to be 5000 Newton meter. We'll equate it with the equation E is equals to 1/2 multiplied by I multiplied by omega max square minus omega min square. Okay, so this will be in a bracket. I we can calculate, that is 1000. Its mass is given as 1000 and the radius of gyration is given as 0.4 square. So this is mass, this is radius of gyration. Again, this is n max. The value of n max is given as 950 and n minimum we have to calculate. Okay, so this we can calculate, n minimum is equals to 919.5 RPM. Okay, so this was pretty straightforward. And again, number of rivets per hour, this is again straightforward question, that is the energy supplied by the motor, that is rating of motor. So 5000 multiplied by 3600. Why it is 3600? Because it is asked per hour and this is given per second. So for 1 hour, how much energy it will be giving out, that will be 5000 multiplied by 3600. And how much energy is required in one operation, that is even, it is given us as 10,000. So this comes out to be 1800 rivets per hour. So I hope this is clear to you. And this was pretty straightforward question. Similar, so this will be the approach in solving such questions. See, they are very easy. Once you understand the relation between the rated power and the terminologies which are used in the equations. Okay, such type of questions. So you may take the screenshot of this question number. Okay, try to solve it at home and we'll discuss this in the next class. Just take the screenshot and I'll close the class. So thank you everybody for joining the class. Thank you.